We don't need that. No, people are dying today. If we had a test that was as sensitive as a PCR test that people could use every single day, sure. But we don't have that, and PCR won't get there anytime soon. These kinds of tests are essentially little paper strip tests. This is what they look like. You can see them here. They are the type of test that can be made for pennies, essentially. And that means they can be made today is the important thing. If the federal government could get behind producing these tests, could actually put their resources and their wherewithal into the manufacturing of them. The design is already out there. You can download blueprints for how to make these tests today. Anyone can view it and could even just send it to a manufacturer and start doing it. But to really scale them up to the numbers we need, we just need the government to start making them. And they are absolutely accurate enough to detect most people who are most transmissible with this virus. And so we don't actually need greater sensitivity at the moment if our goal is to stop transmission at the community level, to stop outbreaks from happening. We just need a test that can reach enough people to have, you know, millions and millions of Americans use them all the time, maybe every day or 3 days. These don't need to reach every single American. These are tests that only need to be used, for example, in hotspots where cases are raging and the outbreak remains out of control, where people continue to die. So let's say we have 20 million of these tests available a day or 30 million available a day, and everyone uses them every 3 days. That's 90 million people in the United States who could be using these tests on any given week. That is more than enough to currently suppress the outbreaks that are happening and make the whole community, the whole country, much safer.